What's up, everyone? Welcome to Power Play with CJ. I just want to focus in on one of the bigger questions concerning hockey, especially the Hall of Fame process. I talked about Phil Housley and getting in and a few other guys that need to get in that aren't in yet. But the biggest question is Lindros. Literally, he's a big boy, 6'5", 235 pounds. But just his Hall of Fame candidacy, you got to look at it as 865 points in an injury-shortened career. 760 games played, never reached 1,000 games. But you look at him at his best, he was one of the greatest NHL players of all time. When he was at his best with the Flyers in the 90s, there were few of any NHL players in any era that were as good as him. And that's just the reality of the situation. Now, one issue with Lindros was obviously the concussions and the injuries that the aforementioned, career getting cut short by them. But the other thing was, growing up, and Theo Fleury, who played with him in New York, mentioned this in his book, Lindros played with his head down because he was so big no one could touch him. And then in the league, the Scott Stevens of the world can freight train you. And Fleury said point blank, at 5'6", if he played like that, he would have been dead by bands. That's just, it was a bad habit that got picked up, and that definitely played a factor in his career, not lasting as long as it should have. But going a step further, 75 points in 61 games as a rookie, won the MVP in the lockout shortened 94-95 season, having 70 points in 46 games. If I remember correctly, Ed Jovanovski gave him fifth in the playoffs. No, that was the next year, 96, when the Panthers won the finals. I don't know why I remember that. There's random old games on the NHL package on the PS3, or whatever, yeah, the end of tablet and everything. So I was watching old fucking Panthers Flyers playoff games from the Florida in the final. Just random stuff that I do. So I did a lot in college and got wasted. But going a step further, the other thing that, and as I keep repeating that, says the other thing that hurts Lindros in the eyes of the voters is he was not well liked around the league. When he was in New York, him and Messier never really saw eye to eye. Literally, they saw eye to eye because they were both big guys, but that was an issue. And I know for a fact Terry O'Reilly, who's an assistant with the Rangers at that time, did not like him one bit. The attitude, the selfishness. I think it's funny. I've met people who lived in his neighborhood in South Jersey and said he was a great guy. Great played street hockey with the kids, stuff like that. But that reputation around the league is hurting him. But at the end of the day, as much as I want to say you need to be dominant for longer, you can't look at those numbers and be like, wow, he's not a Hall of Fame talent. I think he should get in. I think he's paid his, proverbially debt to society. And there's a long list of guys that need to get in. Andrew Chuck. First of all, the fact that it took Pavel Bure, like the fifth ballot to get in, is obscene. That's a different story entirely. But Andrew Chuck, Housley, guys like that need to get in. And I think Lindros in that mix. Lindros was one of the apex players in the NHL for, a few years. And he never played 82 games in a season. He played 81 with the Rangers in 2002, 2003. So that's, they tell you, if he's healthy and plays 1,000 games, he ends up with, what, 1,200 points. That gets you in. And I think you gotta look at the numbers and say what could have been. And I think they're good enough. At his best, he was good enough for his Hall of Fame talent. I mean, 93, 94, 65 games played, 44 goals, 53 assists, 97 points, 103 penalty minutes. The penalty minutes, the tenacity, the size, he was, the big E. He was like nothing the game had ever seen before. Just a guy that dominated the puck, like no one else, and was able to facilitate and have, the skill set of guys that are a lot smaller than he was. He was a power forward. And I think you got to look at the impact he had on the game, physically, on the stat sheet, and then say, all right, you know what? If he was healthy, there's no way in hell he's not one of the all-time leading scorers in the league. So you got to, I if it were up to me, you put him in. But I don't know, the bad reputation, the injuries, that's gonna come back to bite him in the ass. And it's I think that's the situation we're in now. Anyway, that's why this episode of the Power Play with CJ and Eric Lindros Hall of Fame candidacy. See you in more episodes for the season and beyond. Later, guys.